How did you survive that?
Girls were a piece of cake. It was the boy. Every look on his face, every stupid decision he made, the way he sat there chewing his food like an idiot. And then it hit me why this kid drove me so crazy. He's me.
Well, all the more reason she should listen to me. I can stop her from making the same mistakes.
Did you listen to your mother?
No, oh, God, no. But, you know, I had a reason. That woman was a psycho control freak.
Hey, Mom. I brought you some soda, but I couldn't find any straws, so you'll have to drink it like cats.
Oh, thank you, Luke.
That's my sweetie.
I was going to bring you wine, but you finished the big bottle last night.
Okay, off you go.
Hold this, will you, kid? You know, Mitchell used to caddy for me. Of course, he spent most of his time chasing butterflies.
You won't catch me doing that.
Good for you.
I'm terrified of them.
Huh. Look at that. That's a perfect shot. And I hit that with a bent club.
So you're not worried about getting in trouble? You know, with God?
Oh, I think he's got bigger things on his plate.
So you're not worried about hell?
Let me let you in a little secret, kid. There is no hell.
Seriously? No hell? That's fantastic! So everyone just goes to heaven?
Yep. End of story.
Even bad people?
Yeah, they're in another section. See, they got this thing figured out. Can I hit this? Damn it. You distracted me.
I didn't say anything.
I could hear you thinking.
I'm thinking about this heaven of yours that's full of bad people.
Not full, the tiniest fraction. They're walled in.
What if they break out?
They're surrounded by a lake of fire.
There are fiery lakes in heaven. This is turning into hell.
Tell me about it.
What are you doing?
Well, you promised Pepper broken dishes, so I'm breaking dishes.
No, not my frog. I know you think it's tacky, but I happen to have won this at my first 4-H summer camp in a hollering contest.
Well, we wouldn't have to break anything if you were a better liar.
If you're trying to make me feel bad about not being as good a liar as you, what are you doing?
The hat rack fell through the window, remember? One, two, three.
Mitchell, wait. I can't do this. I quit. You might be comfortable with all this lying, but I'm not.
Oh, please, where was all this conscience when I got us into the first class lounge at the airport and you chewed Angela Lansbury's ear off? You know what you are? You're like a mob wife.